Hey everyone, Rod the Tool Guy here at ARES Tools. Today we're going to talk about brake system service. We've got our manual brake bleeder here, the 70921 fluid bleeder. It's got a 2-liter capacity. It comes with a 42 millimeter cap that gives you a lot of coverage. It's a screw style cap. And we also have our 18007 12-piece master cylinder adapter set made to be used with our brake pressure bleeder. One of the most overlooked things on a vehicle probably is when it comes to fluid services is a lot of people don't do anything about the complete fluid change of their brake system. And you should do that about every 2 years because that fluid's got a lot of properties to it that protect your system and keep it efficient. And if you don't change it out, it starts dropping in efficiency and corrosion can start. So it's really good to do that service. So with these tools, you can do that, and I'll open this baby up and show it to you. Nice case, keeps everything organized. And in here you can see we've got a lot of adapters here. It gives you great coverage with all kinds of master cylinders, including your old cast iron guys for your old school cars, you know, your classics, whatever. And also, even if you don't have a screw or bayonet style top, and this has got a locking collar on this adapter, so you can put the adapter in and then lock the collar around it to hold it in. It works out pretty well. So it gives you pretty complete coverage. If you look in our listings, it'll give you further identification on everything that it'll do for you. So what we did is we went into the shop with my vehicle. And I knew I had to service the front brakes, and I was going to use that opportunity to demonstrate this stuff, which we did. And so we serviced up the front brakes and did a complete fluid change and got a little bit of a surprise about the rear brakes, and you'll see in the demos what happened there. So that gave us another opportunity to use one of our other brake system tools. And this is our vacuum brake bleeder, the 70923. And all you have to do with this thing is put your air fitting on here, hook it up to your air. You've got your line, suction line here, the little cap thing that goes on your bleeder here. So we got a chance after I did the complete system bleed. I came back after I got the parts together to do the rear brakes because I wasn't sure, I didn't know I was going to have to do them, but found out we did. And so since the fluid was changed out, I just needed to get the air out of the system. And so I was able to use this tool here to take care of that. It worked really well. I'm very pleased with our brake service system. And we have a lot of other brake tools. We've got great flip sockets, and you got your rear shoe retaining spring remover. We've got things for pushing your pistons in. You get into our listings, you'll see that. So whether you're servicing up your newer style, whether you're taking care of your old school, changing out them nasty calipers for whatever reason, sticking, binding, frozen bleeders, frozen caliper pins, all that type of stuff, you can do it. We've got a complete brake service line to help you out. So we're going to go and show you the clips from the servicing of the brakes, and then we'll come back to the studio and round it all up and finish it out for you. Okay, as you can see, we're out of the studio and in the shop, and got a vehicle on the lift here, and we're going to go ahead and service up the front brakes, and then we're going to pressure bleed the whole system to renew the fluid. So basically, you know, I'm going to repeat some of the things I've already said. You want your safety glasses, gloves, things like that. And if you are lifting a vehicle, jack stands or however, make sure that it's secure. Don't need anything falling down. And so be familiar with your system too, for your bleeding procedures and things like that. When it comes to brakes, we can't afford to make a mistake. So we'll show you how to set up the pressure bleeder on this thing and get her done. Okay, so we've got our pressure bleeder hooked up to our master cylinder here. I got the appropriate adapter out of our master adapter kit there that really gives you some great coverage. You do this very much, you really are going to want that. So one of the things that is important here is to make sure that your master cylinder is clean, and I mean really clean around the cap and stuff. You don't want any of that dirt getting inside there after you do this procedure. And also you want to make sure that you've got the right appropriate brake fluid on these caps. It'll say .3 or .4, whatever it happens to be. And you want to use fluid from a new sealed container. That way it's not contaminated in any way. You're getting good fresh fluid in there. There's a whole bunch of chemistry that goes behind that fluid that I could get into, and I'm not going to do that. It's just, trust me, you want clean, fresh fluid from a sealed container. You go ahead and fill up your bleeder to about here. I usually put a quart in at a time. You go ahead and pressure this thing up to about 10 psi, and you can see it pushing the fluid. You see a few bubbles. Don't mind those bubbles because they're going to go away. They'll collect in the top here, and it won't be a problem. You can always bleed it a little from the fitting if it bothers you, but it's not a concern. So this is basically how you set it up. And remember, you want to go to the wheel that's the furthest away from the master cylinder. And that's where it's important to knowing your systems, because sometimes the ABS unit is located in a place that makes the right rear not the furthest brake line. So you always want to be aware of that. On this one, my ABS unit is midway underneath on the frame rail, but my right rear is the furthest away on their bleeding procedure by manufacturer on this. So we'll go to the rear and start bleeding this thing out. And you'd be surprised, this thing holds pressure really well. And you don't want to excessively pressure it, because that can create problems too. So the 10 PSI works great. Okay, so we're here at the right rear. And as you can see, I have a container here. Basically, what you do is get yourself some tubing from the store, and you can put a hole on top of any kind of container, put it down in there, and catch your fluid so you don't make a big mess. And the nice thing about this is when you open the line, you can see any air bubbles coming out. So if you've serviced the brake system, had it open, like we have on the front, you'll make sure all the air is out there in the front. So I'll show you that when we get up there, because we got to make sure that that's all good and bled out after servicing the brakes. So we'll start here, and we've got that 10 PSI on there. And I'm using a boxed in wrench here. And as you can see, here comes the fluid. And it starts to come through. And if you've got really ugly fluid, you'll definitely notice the difference when it turns. Now the fluid that I'm using here has a kind of a green color to it, so you can kind of see it. There's some brands out there that have different colors, so you can definitely see the change. So we'll go ahead and bleed this right rear out, then do the left rear, and then we'll head to the front and get the air out of those brakes we serviced. Okay, so we've serviced the front brakes, rotors, and pads. One of the things I always like to do is open my bleeders before I do anything to make sure they're not going to break off, and I'm going to have reman calipers. It's kind of nice to know that ahead of time. It's important on these newer brake systems to go ahead and break that bleeder loose before you push the piston back in there, so you're not pushing any garbage up into the system. You push it into the ABS unit. You don't want to have to buy one of those. So we've got it set up here, and I know we're in tight here. I just kind of wanted to let you see how good the system works when it pushes the fluid up the line, and you can see it travel in the air. And as you can see, it's starting to come up the line. There's a big air bubble pushing right through right there. And it just works really slick, and you don't need a ton of pressure. And you don't need one of them big, expensive diaphragm bleeder systems. This works just as well. So we'll finish this all up and be sure you get things cleaned up. Put your rubber cap, protective caps back on the nipples of the bleeders when you're done. Keeps the dirt out for next time. And so we'll see you back in the studio and talk more about this. Okay, so how things normally go when you work on cars, you make discoveries. And we did on this when we were pressure bleeding it. The rear brakes needed service. I didn't know that at the time. My parking brake wasn't working very well, and so I went to adjust it up, and the hardware wouldn't allow for adjustment. It's seen a lot of salt on the roads here because we've taken it up in the mountains and done some skiing, things like that. And when you go over those passes, you get that stuff in there. So I thought I'd take an opportunity to show you also another tool. Since we've already basically flushed this system, and I opened it up to push the pistons back so I didn't push any garbage up into the system. Not that there should have been any in there, but I'm not going to take any chances. So I'm going to use the ARES 70923 vacuum bleeder on this because we know we have good fluid in the system, and our objective at this point is to get air out. So this is a perfect tool for that. So I'm going to set this up and get a little closer in. And so a couple of things that I want to mention on this thing. One, you always want to make sure you've got a good grip on the bleeder here, because you'll get air from out here in and not get the air out of the brake system. The other thing is I see guys do is they open the bleeder and they turn it a bunch of turns. And so they're actually sucking air through the threads on the bleeder because they've backed it out too far and it's not getting all the air out of the brake system. So you just want to crack it open enough that you're getting fluid through there so that you're not pulling excessive air and leaving air in the brake system. Just a couple of things to watch for when you're doing this. So we'll get set up and we'll bleed this thing. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and bleed this here. Getting all set up here. As you can see, our bleeder's here. Like I said, you don't wanna open it too much because then you're just letting air from the outside in. Make sure you're on there real good. So then I'm gonna apply air and lock in the handle and open the bleeder and suck it out. And then I'm gonna close it before I take the air off. And so once I start the air, it's going to be kind of noisy, so just bear with me a minute here. Okay, so you can see the fluid is going through the line, and it's going to be coming into the container here. And I didn't expect there to be a lot of air in there. There was just some. So this has worked out real well, and I think we've got it. So we'll go ahead and lock her down. Now you can see the fluid in here. There we go. And it does a good job of sucking the fluid through. And so now I know that the air is out of the caliper and I can safely proceed. Okay, so you've seen our 70921 brake bleeder, our 18007 master cylinder adapter kit, and our 70923 at work. So basically, you know, with these combination of tools, there's just not anything you can't really take care of. So basically, you just got to make sure that you keep everything clean and you're using that fresh fluid. Make sure you get your caps on right, and when you're using your adapters, just make sure they're on there good and tight so that you're not getting brake fluid all over the place, because your brake fluid can damage paint, so you want to make sure you keep everything clean. Basically, dispose of your fluids properly in a responsible manner, and thank you for watching. Be safe out there. Register your tools. Join our club, and we'll see you next time.